Hello and welcome to another episode of Medicine Can Be Easy. Today we'll start with the physiology of the cell, and we are going to look at its organization and structure, the cell membrane and three organelles, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes and Golgi apparatus. Let's start by looking at the way the cell is organized. The cell has two major components, the nucleus and the cytoplasm. They both have a membrane. The nuclear membrane separates the cytoplasm from the nucleus, and the cell membrane separates the cytoplasm from the surrounding fluids. There's one more term that we need to understand, and that's protoplasm. Protoplasm is basically all the different substances which together make up the cell. And there are five basic ones: water, electrolytes, proteins, lipids, and carbohydrates. We'll start with water. Water forms 70 to 85% of the cell and contains different dissolved chemicals. Then we have ions. The most important ions found in the cell are potassium, magnesium, phosphate, sulfate, bicarbonate, but also sodium, chloride, and calcium. The cell needs them for cellular reactions, but also for some of the cellular control mechanisms. Now let's take a look at lipids. The most important lipids are phospholipids and cholesterol, which are used to form the cell membrane and intracellular membrane barriers that separate the different cell compartments. And then we have carbohydrates that are used for the cell nutrition. Now let's look at proteins. Proteins represent 10 to 20% of the cell and are usually divided into two groups: structural proteins and functional proteins. Structural proteins usually form long filaments which provide the cytoskeletons of different organelles, and they can be found in the form of collagen and elastin fibers in connective tissue and blood vessel walls, ligaments, etc. Functional proteins, on the other hand, are usually composed of combinations of a few molecules. They mainly serve as enzymes, which for example catalyze specific intracellular chemical reactions, and they are mobile in the cell fluid. Now that we understand what protoplasm is and which substances it contains, let's go back and talk about the cell membrane. The cell membrane is a thin and elastic structure which is only 7.5 to 10 nanometers thick. Its basic structure is a lipid bilayer. That means two layers of lipids, among which we can find large globular protein molecules. This bilayer is composed of phospholipid molecules that have two ends. One end is soluble in water, and this one is called hydrophilic. The other one is soluble only in fats, and it is called hydrophobic. The hydrophobic portions tends to attach to one another in the middle of the membrane, whereas the hydrophilic portions form the two surfaces of the complete cell membrane. One is in contact with the intracellular fluid on the inside of the membrane, and the other with the extracellular fluid on the outside surface. So this is the basic structure of the cell membrane. The cell membrane contains two main substances: lipids and proteins. Lipids are insoluble in water, so they create a barrier that impedes the movement of water and water-soluble substances from one cell compartment to another, because water is not soluble in lipids. That's the reason why we have the lipid layer in the middle, which is impermeable to water-soluble substances such as ions or glucose. But because we want to be able to pass some substances through the membrane, we have proteins that can provide specialized pathways which we can use to pass specific substances through the membrane. These proteins in the membrane are usually glycoproteins, and they can be divided into two groups: integral and peripheral proteins. Integral proteins penetrate all the way through the membrane. Peripheral proteins are attached to only one surface of the membrane and they don't penetrate all the way through. The function of many integral proteins is to provide channels. We can also call them pores for water molecules and water-soluble substances that can then diffuse between the extracellular and intracellular fluids. They can also be used as carrier proteins that transport substances that otherwise wouldn't be able to penetrate the lipid bilayer. They can also serve as receptors for water-soluble chemicals that do not easily penetrate the cell membrane. Now, the peripheral proteins are often attached to integral proteins. They usually function as enzymes or they control the transport of substances through the cell membrane channels. Okay? However, there's one more important substance in the cell membrane, carbohydrates. Membrane carbohydrates are found almost always in combination with proteins or lipids as glycoproteins or glycolipids. One portion of their molecules hangs from the cell surface. These portions create the so-called glycocalyx, a loose carbohydrate coat around the entire cell. And there are several functions of the carbohydrate molecules. Many of them have a negative electrical charge, which creates an overall negative surface charge that repels other negative objects. The glycocalyx of one cell can sometimes attach to the glycocalyx of another cell and then attach cells to one another. Many carbohydrates serve as receptor substances that bind hormones, and some even enter into immune reactions. Now that we understand all of this, let's finally look at the organelles of the cell. Organelles are highly organized physical structures inside the cell. Most of them are covered by membranes that are again composed of mainly lipids and proteins. And the first organelle we're going to talk about is the endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum is simply a network of tubular and flat vesicular structures in the cytoplasm that are connected to one another. Their walls are constructed of lipid bilayer membranes that contain large amounts of proteins that are similar to the cell membrane. The space inside the tubules and vesicles is filled with endoplasmic matrix, a watery medium. The endoplasmic reticulum's function is to transport substances. Substances from different parts of the cell enter the space of endoplasmic reticulum and they are then sent to other parts of the cell. Also, endoplasmic reticulum plays a significant role in the metabolic function of the cell. We distinguish two types of the endoplasmic reticulum, the granular and agranular endoplasmic reticulum. Granular endoplasmic reticulum has large number of tiny granular particles that are called ribosomes. These ribosomes are attached to the outer surface of the endoplasmic reticulum and they are composed of a mixture of RNA and proteins. Their function is to synthesize new protein molecules in the cell. The agranular endoplasmic reticulum has no attached ribosomes. Because it has no granules, it's called agranular. A indicates negative in Latin. And it is used for the synthesis of lipid substances and for different processes of the cell that need intrareticular enzymes. Finally, we have the Golgi apparatus. It is composed of four or more layers of thin, flat, enclosed vesicles that lie near one side of the nucleus. And it has similar membranes as the agranular endoplasmic reticulum. It works in association with the endoplasmic reticulum, and the process is as follows. First, the endoplasmic reticulum vesicles, and those are small transport sacs, are transported from the endoplasmic reticulum to the Golgi apparatus. The Golgi apparatus processes them and forms lysosomes, secretory vesicles, and other cytoplasmic components. And we will talk about all of these different organelles, mitochondria, nucleus, and the cell cytoskeleton in the next video, so stay tuned. I hope that this video helped you to understand more about the cell, its organization, and different organelles. If you like this video, then please subscribe to learn more about the cell, physiology, and much more. If you would like to study medicine more efficiently, then maybe check our video, The Key to Success in Medical School, or if you'd like to see how you can use your knowledge of anatomy in clinical medicine, check our video on left and right-sided heart failure. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.